Thank you for being here today to officially declare March 30, which is tomorrow, the Welcome Home Vietnam Veterans Day in Washington State. Over 200,000 veterans hold the great state of Washington their home. Now, a lot of these veterans did not serve in Vietnam. They supported the Vietnam War. They were the ones who took care of the Vietnam veterans who were injured, who came home, who needed help. So Vietnam veterans, please give yourself a great round of applause. Now, the governor signed today a bill that declares March 30th Welcome Home Vietnam Veterans Day. But a bill does not take place unless you have a legislature that is willing and able to push it through and ensure that it gets to the governor's office. The Yakima Warriors proposed a bill. Representative Johnson and other senators and legislators actually got the Senate and the House to be able to go get those to his desk. And it's important for us to be able to recognize that our legislatures support fully our Vietnam veterans and veterans overall in Washington State. And I would like to introduce today the members of the legislature who are here today who helped make this day possible. Principally, Representative Johnson. And help me hold the applause because I need to introduce a few other people, quite a few of them. Representative McCoy, Representative Ross, Senator Conway, and Senator Roach. We have several other legislators in here that made time to be able to be with us. That's Representative Angel, Representative Smith, Senator Shin, Senator Benton, Senator Hobbs, Senator Chase, and Senator Hatfield, and Representative Coachmar. Thank you for being here. Thank you for your support, because without you, this law would have not been signed today. Thank you very much. Today's celebration coincides with efforts at the national level to ensure our nation pays tribute to nearly 8 million Vietnam veterans living in the United States of America, with commemoration events to mark the 50th anniversary of the Vietnam War. I have with me something we received yesterday. Washington State is now a commemorative partner with the Department of Defense to be able to commemorate the 50th anniversary of the Vietnam War. We got the flag, we have the certificate, and what this does for Washington State is that we're making a commitment from here and on to be able to deliberately celebrate not only on the 30th of March, but throughout the entire year with events and recognitions, not just in Olympia, but all over Washington State to ensure that a grateful state thanks our Vietnam veterans. And I would like to give an opportunity. We have a couple of our senators and representatives that are going to be making some remarks. Representative Johnson.
Thank you very much, Alfie. You know, it's gratifying to see so many of you here who have served our nation, and particularly those of you who served in Vietnam, because this was not always a pleasant time when they came home. You know, as I stand here by the wall, I can't help but think when I stood by the graveside of my cousin, who was laid to rest next to his father, and watched his mother as she buried her only son. You know, those were extremely sad days for any of us. And I hope that this will in some way help to make that a little bit easier on those of you who served and served so valiantly in a war that was not particularly popular anywhere in the world, let alone here in the United States. But I want to single out one individual who really, I feel, brought this to mine and Representative McCoy and Representative Ross's attention, and that was Gil Clack. And Gil, wave your arm back there, would you please? I had the honor of meeting with the Yakima Warriors Association last year when we finished our session here in Olympia. And Gil led several of them to me and said, you know, people who served in Vietnam were never thanked. And you know, I hope this is some little way of saying thank you Vietnam veterans, and God bless each and every one of you. Now I'd like to call on Representative McCoy, and he'll call on the next one. John is our chairman of Tribal Affairs and Community Housing. He's been a wonderful man to work for. I sit on his committee. Thank you, and here's John.
Good morning. It's great to see you all out here to celebrate this great PRISLA legislation. It is about time to honor the veterans that were in Vietnam and those that, you know, served the Vietnam era. I myself only got as far as Clark Air Base. My duty station was across the street from the morgue, so that was tough. But my wife worked in the base hospital, and she had to walk through and around all those troops that were wounded, that were still in their battle gear, and walking around them to service those. So she came out of there a little tougher than I did. But she was happy to do it. Took her a while to get over it, but we're there now, and she did. She's back home at Tulalip, and she sends her regards, where she could have been here. So, but then this is for all of you that have served, and especially you families that had to stay at home and worry about your loved one and hoping that they came home. So it's about time that we did this. I know some folks have said that this is too little too late, but in my opinion, it's never too late. It's about time. So thank you. And Representative Ross.
Thank you very much for the opportunity to visit with you today. I was struck by many things today. As a younger person in life, I have always looked for moments that create clarity in my own mind. I'm going to share with you two of them quickly today. But I want to kind of preface this by saying one thing. When the country called, who answered? You did. And that call for some was to give some, and that call for others was to give everything. There are people amongst us today who have names etched on that wall that are a family member of them. And I want to first tell them that I'm very sorry for the tragic loss that you have in your heart. But know that this country is grateful for people's individual courage to defend liberty wherever called to serve. Thank you. There was a time in my life when I had the distinct honor and privilege to sail into Pearl Harbor on a U.S. aircraft carrier named the Kitty Hawk. Standing in my dress uniform and peering over the edge of the carrier and seeing the sunken hulks of warships under that water has remained in my memory ever since the day I saw it. Because inside those vessels are veterans that were never recovered. And they died fighting for the country that we live in today. Many of your family members served in a different era, but were giving and putting themselves in exactly the same harm. We are a tremendous nation of people. Today I saw one more image that will stay in my mind, I hope, until I am gone. And it was an image of Gil this morning carrying the national banner into the House of Representatives. In his headdress, he was carrying the national flag. And it was symbolic to me in the fact that no matter who you are in this country, no matter what your background is, most likely those red, white, and blue colors mean to you the same as they do to me, which is freedom. And I hope that your service as military members, Vietnam veterans, that your service will remain a beacon of hope for generations that are coming behind us, so that they will be as proud of I am, of my dad, as my boys will be as proud of me. That is the American way of life. Thank you, and God bless you. Thank you. I have the distinct honor of introducing Senator Pam Roach. She was a huge help, her and Senator Conway, in bringing this bill through the Senate on a very fast track.
Well, thank you very much. It's a great honor to be here, as we are all honored in being here, because we get to think of those who have served, who've come home, and those that didn't. This is a wonderful memorial. You know, I can't really continue until I mention that among our legislators, we've had many who served in Vietnam, but one that stands out in my mind is former Senator Leo Thorsness, who was a Medal of Honor winner and was prisoner of war for 7 years. In North Vietnam, he was shot down, and that was his plight. His name came to mind recently when my own son, Captain John Roach, was in training, and on the wall there were listening, you had the pictures of some of our heroes. And my son took a picture of this and sent it to me because he knew I'd served with Leo. The interesting thing is, on the wall plaque, they spelled Leo's name wrong. I guess we'll have to get that fixed. It's truly an honor to be here to represent the legislature, those of us that are here today doing that. It's such an honor to serve, and it's an honor to serve veterans in our state. The legislature has done some things in the past. We have now a Joint Select Committee on Military and Veterans Affairs, and several of us here serve on that committee. I've been a pleasure to serve on it since its inception. I've been its co-chair at one point, and we get to see a lot of issues that deal with veterans, both in the Vietnam era, actually the World War II era, Korean era, and even today when we're struggling with post-traumatic stress syndrome, which we probably didn't notice during the Vietnam era, and individuals with traumatic brain injuries, which is more the signature injury of the conflict today. But we're doing what we can to reach out, and a group that helps us do that is the Veterans Legislative Coalition, and there are several gentlemen mostly that are here today representing them. They are a liaison group, really, to the legislature. They help us recognize the issues and give us ways to find ways to show appreciation, even if it's something as relatively small as helping to fund a golf course in the Lakewood area for disabled veterans. Things, anything we're looking for to do to show our appreciation and our thanks. America has changed. Now, I grew up in a situation where I was pretty much had that flag on my heart as I do today, and I was very aware of the unrest that occurred. But the thing is, we've healed, and the important thing is this, that those who came home from Vietnam having served, who didn't get the thank you, can now, as they age, and we've said goodbye to many World War II veterans, my father passed away last year, and these things tug at our hearts. But there's closure, I think, now, hopefully, for those that came home from the Vietnam conflict, that now, finally, the thank you is there in a much more vocal way, and you actually have, can you imagine, would you have thought, legislatures and people across the country just working as hard as they can, I think, to make up for lost ground. I hope that you and your hearts will forgive those that didn't see what was really the fact. If you'll, when we speak on the Senate, we say, Mr. President, meaning, may I read? And I have a favorite, and I'd love to share it with you if I may. It's called The Soldier. It's the soldier, not the reporter, who's given us freedom of the press. It's the soldier, not the poet, who's given us freedom of speech. It's the soldier, not the poet, who's given us freedom of speech. If you can read this message, you thank a teacher. If you're reading this in English of your own free will, you thank a soldier. It is the soldier, not the campus organizer, who gave us the freedom to demonstrate. It is the soldier, not the lawyer, who has given us the right to a free trial. It is the soldier who salutes the flag, who serves under the flag, and whose coffin is draped by the flag, who allows the protester to burn the flag. To all the brave men and women who've dedicated or given their lives to protecting this country and freedom, we say thank you. And for those of us who only stood and waited, and I was one of those, we shared also. And thank you so much for being here today, and I praise my fellow legislators for the good work that they're doing. Thank you so much.
Senator Steve Conway here, and I want to actually take my little time here to thank the Veterans of Foreign Wars Narrows Bridge Post for having brought this resolution to me. Would you wave your hand? They're over there, and I'm not convinced what was going on in the House. I got involved in it through their request of me to make have a floor resolution on the floor of the Senate for this day. And of course, then we found the bill that was signed today, Welcome Home Vietnam Veterans Bill. And, you know, I'm kind of struck by what's going on here, because we are the eighth state to make this law. And three other states are considering it right now. So I imagine in time we'll see all 50 states having done this and honoring our Vietnam veterans in a very special way. Welcome home. That's an interesting phrase, an important phrase. And it is, you know, it's a fitting to me that we've set a day for this. You know, March 30th, because I think as we stand here by the wall, I think of the many, many, many veterans and family members and others who have come here to stand here and resolve so many, many feelings. And I know many of you have probably here been to the War Memorial on the Capitol grounds in D.C. too. And here we find resolution. And I think that March 30th will become a similar type of day for resolution and for sharing, I might add. I was struck, we had a celebration at the VFW Hall, and you know, over 80 people were there, and I saw families talking about the war and talking about their experiences. And that is healing. And, you know, I think that's very important. And I think having this 50th anniversary of Vietnam War is going to initiate a lot of that conversation. I'm a historian, so, you know, I really believe that that is important. And I might add that something that I see Senator Steve Hobbs, he was here. I didn't hear his name mentioned, but Senator Hobbs has said several things on the floor of the Senate, in fact, twice now, today again, saying thank you to you Vietnam veterans for having helped him, a veteran of Afghanistan and Iraq, to come home to a people who says, we respect what you've done and we welcome. And so we must, as President Obama said, resolve ourselves never again to let any veteran come home from a war and not have that hand out to them and make sure that they come back and they are taken care of. So thank you very much. It's been a great honor to be here.
you know that we would not be here today if not for the efforts of the Yakima Warriors Association, led by Commander Vic Woods. Commander, could you please come to the podium?
Veterans, members of the House, members of the Senate, special guests, I thank you for being here today. May I say welcome. Like Moses of the Bible, we've been wandering for 40 years. Now we've finally been welcomed home. It truly is a Good Friday. My name is Victor Wood. I currently serve as head warrior for the Yakima Warriors Association. I served from 1969 to 1973 in the United States Navy. I was an aviation ordnanceman. My tour was with Fighter Squadron 161 aboard the USS Midway, 72 and 73. When this adventure first started, I would tell people about House Bill 1319. Some would say, does this mean we get a day off? Most of those people were not veterans. Some would say, man, it's great. It's about time. Most of those people were veterans. We as Vietnam veterans know what welcome home truly means. It means closure, acceptance, pride, honor, and a lessening of guilt for doing what was expected of us under the direction of our country's leaders. Welcome home, it really does have a sweet ring. We must take the time to remember what this day would have meant to the veterans that are no longer with us. I know that they would be proud today. I'd like to take this opportunity to thank Representative Norm Johnson for introducing House Bill 1319. Welcome home, Vietnam veterans, Washington State. Norm, you've been a good friend to our association, and we appreciate all your hard work. I would also like to thank the following people: our governor, the Honorable Jay Inslee, the House of Representatives, members of the Senate, Heidi Adep, Communications Director for Washington State Veterans Affairs. We truly appreciate your hard work. Dwayne Drake. Dwayne, raise your hand. Dwayne went out and raised a ton of money for some pens that we're going to hand out a little bit later to the Vietnam veterans. Pam Mayhew and Rebecca Corpus for all the logistics in getting us over here. Andy Thompson for all the Facebook notifications. Richard Walker and Kitsap News for their articles. Roy Dick from the Yakima Nation Radio for all their airtime, and all the veterans who passed the word on Facebook and by word of mouth. And I also want to iterate on Gil. Gil was our squeaky wheel, and I know there's some people who are probably going to cut the wires on their phones now that this is all over. That was very unselfish what you did for us, Gil. We appreciate it. Without these people, this day would not have been possible. Let's give them a round of applause. In a little while, we'll be bringing out the drums. We will share traditional songs and dances. I ask you to please join us. The circle is our way of showing unity and friendship. The circle is strong, as is the bond between brothers and sisters of like experiences. Let the Creator witness our unity, our pride, and finally our acceptance. Also, let's not forget those that cannot be here with us today. Remember, we all gave some, but some gave all. It is our responsibility to carry on their legacy. We have been finally, officially welcomed home. I thank all those that helped make this day possible. And it really and truly is a Good Friday. Thank you.
Before we continue with the program, I would like to take just a moment to be able to encourage everyone, you Vietnam veterans, especially those who were in country, those of you who know a Vietnam veteran who is your neighbor, or somebody who goes to church with you, there have been new conditions may presume connected to Agent Orange and the deployment to Vietnam. those who had the conditions denied in the past years ago, you may want to be able to see if there's anything new that may apply to you as a Vietnam veteran. This nation and the Department of Veterans Affairs, the Federal Department of Veterans Affairs, has recognized that there are additional conditions and illnesses associated with service in Vietnam. So please, let your Department of Veterans Affairs know who you are so that we can help you be able to navigate reopening a claim if we need to do that for you. Because it is important that you access every possible benefit that you earned. The benefits that you earned, this is not charity, you earned that by virtue of your service. So please remember that, and please keep your neighbors and people you know who serve in Vietnam in mind to make sure that they access the State Department of Veterans Affairs so that we can help them. Now, I am honored to turn back the ceremony to Mike Skilks and the Yakima Warriors Association. Thank you.
At this time, there's, you know, we do many things in our culture and in our language. And we have a group that has come here, and they have composed a song that talks about what we are doing today for our Vietnam veterans. And it talks about, it's almost the same interpretation as you heard Wilson talk about when if you was here during the invocation. This song is the same thing, but it's in a different language. But it talks about what these gentlemen did throughout the United States and Canada and the ladies. And so the group is going to sing a soldier boy song for our men today and our ladies. And many of you guys know the composer who has been around veterans all his life. He has also been a traditional man teaching many different dances, teaching the boys and the children how to sing. This song that they're going to sing, this one was composed by Mr. Ken Scabriel. And we ask you to bless this ground.
Soldier boy, soldier boy.
With this Eagle staff. As you see the colors that Gil is wearing, they represent what they have stood for, what they have done, and why we are here today to uphold our culture. our language, our songs, our traditional ways of life. Ask you all to remain standing, and those of you, the veterans, Vietnam veterans. At this time, we want to call upon Lauren. Lauren Corpus, to, as he's going to get ready to play taps. This time, we go upon to the service song. Sing your verses there, your branch.
have a pin for.
And as you heard them mention that they have pins that were specially made for this occasion. And so we ask you, the Vietnam veterans, to get ready to exit to the song of the singers. And there's going to be the children and the grandchildren that are going to hand the pins to each one of you as you exit off the floor. So, singers. And we want to make sure that the Vietnam veterans receive these pins. Veterans, to not leave, to come back into the circle after you receive your pin. So as you guys receive your pins, we ask you to stick around and come back into the circle here. Thank you.
As the veterans are, we'd like to call upon. As you heard them mention throughout the speaking. As they always open up their hands and they're always willing to be a help in any way, and they like to call upon the veterans to come into the circle once again.
Hey, Audrey.
Hey.
Thank you.
Thank you.
His name is Tony Overman from the Olympian.
Oh, really?
I got two cats.
As we call upon all of our veterans to come on into the circle once again. Once again, to bring them into this circle, the sacred circle.